A sweep is a tool or command that is very useful if we want to sweep or push some sketched profile about some sketched path. So, a good example of a sweep here is this simple paperclip design. Now, this design might look fairly complex, and as we can see, we might not be able to create this very easily by just using simple extrusions, cuts, or even revolves. But as we will see, we can create this actually very easily by making use of the sweep tool. And we will see that this object was actually created by two fairly simple sketches, my profile sketch and my path sketch. So let's first take a quick look at the two sketches that were used to create this object. So here we can see the two sketches used to create my sweep. First, I have my profile. In this case, would just be a very simple circle. And then my path is what I would be sweeping or pushing that profile about. And that would be the general path here. So this entire sketch here. Once we have these two sketches, we can very easily create my 3D model by making use of the sweep tool. So let's see how we can create this from scratch. So I'll just start in a new empty design here, and let's start maybe by drawing out the path of my paperclip. So I'll jump maybe to my top view here, and I'm going to start the path at the origin point, and that will just give me a good reference point, as we'll see later on when drawing the profile as well. And I'm not really too worried about the dimensions here, so I'm just going to make up whatever dimensions I may want. Start with a line, and then I'll draw an arc, something like this. And same idea, maybe something like this. And I'm just doing this nice and quickly here, but you get the idea. And there you go. Let's close it out, something like that. And we have the basic shape or path for a paperclip. So now we're essentially halfway there. We've created the path for my paperclip, and now I just need the profile that we'd like to sweep or push about this path. Now, the most important part with sweeps is that you're going to want your profile to probably start or be connected somehow to your path, because again, we're sweeping about that path. So in my case here, maybe I would start my profile, in this case the circular sketch, on this origin point. That's why I used the origin point earlier. And I would probably want my circular profile sketch to be perpendicular or normal to my path sketch, as that circle should be kind of pushed normal to my path sketch. So in this case, I want to draw it on this plane here, essentially, or my left plane. So I'll jump right into my left plane. And now again, this is just going to be a simple circular sketch. So I'll draw a circle somewhere about here. But the important thing is, I would want maybe the center point of my circle to be dead on that origin, so I know that it's going to be right along my path. And now what I like to do when creating my sweeps is, again, take a quick look at a 3D view here, just to see how my profile sketch, that's the circular sketch here, is looking on my path sketch. And so the location here is looking pretty good, right? So the center point of my circle is right at the origin, or kind of the start point of my path. But notice it looks like that dimension of the circle is way too big. As we can see, if we tried to sweep that paperclip, it's going to intersect with itself and cause a bunch of issues. So that circle's just a little bit too large here. So maybe I'll change the size slightly to maybe something more like this. And now that's looking a little bit better. I should be able to hopefully sweep that circular profile sketch about my path. And as usual, I have two methods to jump into my sweep tool. I can manually navigate through the tools and try to find my sweep tool here. But again, I generally like to make use of that selection-based interface that's automatically going to pop up the tools I may want based upon my selection. So again, remember for a sweep, I need two things. I need a profile and a path. So I first can maybe tap to select my profile here. Notice I'm seeing extrude, scale, a few other options there. I don't seem to be seeing sweep, and that might be because I haven't yet selected the profile I'd like to sweep about. So in this case, as soon as I tap a profile to sweep about, now I'm seeing my sweep become available to me within my selection-based interface. Now if I did the sweep right now, notice it's only going to sweep a portion of that profile as I only selected that single line. So that's obviously not exactly what I wanted. So just tap to undo there, and I'll again tap to select my profile, and now tap to select my path. Again, seeing the sweep come in, but I don't just want to sweep about that one line that's being highlighted there. So I want to make sure I grab my entire path here. And now, if I use my sweep tool here, we can see it has now swept that profile about the entire path that I selected. So as we can see, it is a very simple process to create a sweep in Shaper 3D. Generally, we will need two things. We will need a profile sketch, and then we also need a path sketch to sweep that profile about that path.